Friends.
Welcome back.
My name is Ramon.
How are you today?
Here we are, another installment in my top skincare products 2020. This time talking about serums, which is a plentiful category, trust me. I hope this is really helpful for you all, just considering that holidays are right around the corner, and I know it's time that we're all shopping for our fellow skincare friends, or even just for ourselves, because we all deserve a treat yourself moment. Before I get into it, I'm gonna ask that you hit the subscribe button and notification bell so that you know when I post more skincare, sunscreen, and fancy related content on my channel. Give me a thumbs up, and down below, what are some of your favorite actives, treatments, serums of 2020? I have a lot, trust me. Had a hard time choosing what my favorites were. That's why there's literally 17 in front of me right now. But tell me what some of your favorites are or what some of your opinions on the ones I'm gonna mention are. So, as I mentioned, there's a lot of it. My boyfriend was like, can you cap it at like 10? And I was like, no, sorry. I have a lot, but I've categorized them and I'll have the chapters on this little time thing down below. And the main categories are gonna be hydrating, acne specific, and then exfoliating and brightening so that it's a little bit easier to navigate. So I'll get right into it. First and foremost is gonna be my hydrating serums. These are gonna be the most universally applicable for all skin types. As an oily, acne-prone skin individual, most of these are geared towards me and my skin concerns, but if I can recommend these for other people and other skin types and skin concerns, I will specifically address that for each individual product. So, hydrating. First and foremost, the PURITO Centella Green Level Buffet Serum. This is one that I've been waiting to try for a hot minute just because I love PURITO sunscreen. PURITO is such a hyped brand, and I was like, they have such acclaim and such consistently great reviews, and I'm like, I have to try this, and sure enough, this was a home run. This is just a really nice, lightweight, hydrating serum that's really hydrating, but also really soothing and calming for the skin. You got Centella and a lot of other really great anti-inflammatory ingredients. Overall, this is one that I like to use a lot, especially right now in the winter. My skin's a little bit more dry and dehydrated. Layer it on top of my other hydrators, on top of other toners. My skin is plush. Next is a little bit more fun. This is from Glow Recipe. This is their Plump Hyaluronic Serum. My boyfriend loves this, and honestly, this is the most richly hydrating but lightweight hyaluronic acid serum I've ever used. Hyaluronic acid I'm trying to like steer away from a little bit right now just because it doesn't do a lot for me, I find, but this just feels so good on the skin. You put this on, you lather this on, and your skin feels just like super, super nourished, very, very hydrated, plump. The texture for this is really unique, but more so I just love the sensory of it smells really like lightly sweet. The packaging is really cute, and I've really been enjoying using the Glow Recipe PR I've gotten, and this was, I think, a standout product for me. So if you're willing to splurge a little bit and you like to have a little bit more fun with your skincare, great option. This is like one of the most immediate effects of hydration I feel from a product. And the last hydrating serum is gonna be the Rewind Serum from Stratia. And you know I love Stratia. I actually talked about this in the video I came out with Allie, which go watch it, it's gonna be right up here. What I love about this is that this does a lot for the skin. She calls this her kitchen sink product because it's one of the products where she just puts so much into the formulation of it that it addresses a lot of different skin concerns and whatnot. But fundamentally, this is just a really nice, lightweight hydrating serum, which similar to the Plump from Glow Recipe, it's just a really nice, lightweight, but very instantly gratifying hydrating serum to me. It also features other things like licorice root extract, Centella Asiatica, it features allantoin, so you're getting a little bit more soothing elements out of this as well. So I need a product that's going to do a little bit more for me, and right now I'm all about products that give me multiple benefits. Rewind is where I go, and plus it's just really, really accessible, really affordable, and specifically I love to recommend this for people of color. Next on the list is the category of acne treatment specific actives, and these are the ones that are very near and dear to my heart because again I have oily acne prone skin, so these are ones that I've not been able to put down over the last year of testing and trying out skincare and that I feel deserve a shout out. First and foremost, the Sunday Riley UFO oil. This has been a staple in my skincare routine for like 4 or 5 years now. I've mentioned it in a lot of different videos just because it's a product I always come back to. It has salicylic acid, it has the cumin extract, it has licorice root extract. It has a lot to prevent breakouts, treat curtain breakouts, brighten the aftermath of having breakouts, and really nice plush dry oil texture. It's a oil base just because salicylic acid is not water soluble, but I feel like I can use this in my skincare routine in the serum step still, and I feel it's super lightweight, makes the skin look amazing. And it's just a really fun product to use because I love the smell of it. This is a small size vial of this that's $40 for 0.5 fluid ounces. And I bought this in December and I've barely used half of it. So this will last you a long time using a few drops of this, like maybe twice a week. It's great to use at any point of trying to work around breakouts, preventing them, treating them, aftermath. This was a recent addition to my skincare routine. I got this back in September. This is the Pimple Potion from Kinship. What was really interesting about this is that this features retinaldehyde, as well as salicylic acid, and like a nice lightweight lotion texture, but specifically intended to be an acne treatment. While retinoids are really great for treating acne, retinal is the one that actually has studies proving that it has antibacterial properties to take care of current breakouts. When you have a current breakout, a current cystic acne breakout on your face, that's a buildup of a bacteria underneath your skin. You need to kill that bacteria specifically. Retinal is going to be able to do that. Not only that, you also have salicylic acid in here, and salicylic acid is a lipid-soluble exfoliant, able to get into the pore structure, really break down any impurities in the pore to prevent any clogging and any buildup in the pore that will lead to whiteheads or blackheads. So in effect, this is kind of a multi multifunctional product depending on what kind of issues you have with your skin, pore congestion, blackheads, active breakouts. I use this either as a spot treatment when I have active breakouts, or I don't know if you're supposed to do this. I mix this in with moisturizer, so I get a retinoid rich night cream where I need full face treatment, just because the retinol, as a retinoid, I'm not afraid of putting that around my eye. It's still at the end of the day a retinoid, so you're gonna get the benefits of that. And the salicylic acid to me hasn't caused any irritation around the eye area either. So on nights where I'm doing more preventative treatment, I will mix a little bit of this into a moisturizer, slather it on everywhere. I'm good. And the last serum under the acne category is the Azeclear A15 serum from Facetheory. And azelaic acid is one of my holy grail ingredients. I preach about it incessantly, and I'm actively trying different products that feature azelaic acid to do a dedicated video. This is actually the first of the products I tested for it, and I got this back in September, and this was the product that I could not put down when I first got to London and my skin was out of whack. Azelaic acid has a lot of different benefits. It's primarily a really great acne treatment. It's a gentle exfoliant. It's great at balancing skin sebum levels. It's great at brightening the skin, helping with pore texture. What's great about that is that it does all that with minimal to no skin irritation. On top of that, specifically why I like this one is that it's mixed with colloidal oat, and colloidal oat is another anti-inflammatory agent. And that's also coupled with other humectants and anti-inflammatory properties as well. Like you have glycerin, you have propanediol, you have green tea, you have aloe vera. So what I like about this is that it's a nice azelaic acid serum that's also anti-inflammatory, so that when your skin's a little bit more compromised, this is really nice to use without any fear of irritation. If I can compare this to anything, it's basically a very watered down Great Barrier Relief in terms of the texture and the feel on the skin. While it does have humectants, it's not very hydrating, but I did find a lot of use for this when my skin was really actively breaking out, but also very dry. And the last category is going to be brighteners and exfoliants. And these are, I think, my favorite of all the products that I have, just because I love a good exfoliator. First up on the list, the Soft Touch AHA Serum from Stratia. And what I love about this, again, I talked about this in my video with Ali, the founder of Stratia and the formulator behind Stratia's products, is that it features mandelic acid, one of the most gentle and the least irritating of the AHAs. And she specifically chose it because it was the most widely applicable, widely usable AHA, because even for deeper skin tones, it has less of a risk of irritation and thus pigmentation. What I love about this is that's basically a very nice hydrating gel texture. In this, you have mandelic acid, obviously, but you also have chamomile, you have panthenol, you have aloe, you have allantoin. So I love using this just because I get the exfoliating benefit, but it feels really hydrating on the skin. Next is the Roto Milano CC Brightening Essence. And yes, it's called an essence, but I think that's like a Japanese thing. And it's really just a serum. I had never heard of this before Stylevana sent this to me. And I was like, what is this? And then on Instagram, everyone was like, I love that product. Oh my God, that product works so well for me. And I was like, why is she so hyped up? And then I used it and I was like, oh. This is one of the most unique skincare products I've used in all of 2020, just because this comes out and I was like, oh, it's like an oil. And then I put it on the skin and I was like, why is this so warm? And then it sets to the skin and I was like, oh, this is gone. And it actually did help with a lot of my pigmentation issues right here in the side of my face, just because in my temples especially, I have some of the most stubborn pigmentation that happens. With the unique texture of this, the formulation is just pretty much ascorbic acid, a couple different forms of it, so that it's the most stable that it can be. Coupled with a few other products that are going to help brighten, help balance the skin level, as well as to potentially have some antibacterial properties as well. Really why I like this, which is because you have really stable ascorbic acid, which is the most potent, the most studied form of vitamin C in a vehicle that's very volatile. So you put it on the skin, it sets down and it feels like nothing's there. So this doesn't feel hydrating. It doesn't do a lot more for the skin, but it's just a really good brightening product. And then my last little trio of products is from Naturium. And I love Naturium, that's no secret. And I've raved about these in a few other videos and Instagram posts. What I love about Naturium specifically is at a really great price point, they feature really great active ingredients that give you specific benefit. But not only that, they formulate it with other ingredients to fortify the one main ingredient and its properties while giving you other benefits, as well as being really hydrating and nourishing to the skin. First and foremost, I'm going to talk about the Arbutin serum. This is their alpha arbutin 2%. Arbutin, great brightening ingredient. That's what it's best for. It's also an antioxidant. And on top of that, it's featured with niacinamide and hyaluronic acid. Arbutin brightens. Niacinamide also brightens. Niacinamide, also an antioxidant that helps to strengthen the skin barrier and helps with anti-inflammatory properties. And you also have hyaluronic acid, so it's going to be really hydrating. Super lightweight. Love this in the daytime underneath my sunscreen, but also at night to repair my skin and help with brightening when I really want that brightening punch. A surprise favorite of mine of 2020 was their PHA topical acid, just because in my head, I love high strength, high concentration, like high octane exfoliators. Slatheronic glycolic acid peel, I'm happy. And I was like, PHA, like, what is that gonna do for me? I'm used to a lot more, like I can't see that many benefits from this. Y'all, the next morning after I use this, my skin is always so supple, so hydrated, so glowy, so smooth, and I'm just like, what? Why? Like, so shocked. But in reality for me, this is like similar to Soft Touch in that these are technically exfoliants, but the vehicle for them is so hydrating and so lightweight. They set into the skin really, really nicely that for my oily acne prone skin, it feels like nothing's there, but my skin is still nicely nourished. They also couple this with lingonberry stem cells, which give you a lot of antioxidant punch and help reduce the look of UV induced pigmentation. But it also is coupled with mandelic acid. So it's kind of like Soft Touch just to amp up a little bit of the exfoliating benefits of this. But at the end of the day, it's just a really gentle exfoliant. So if you have really dry skin, skin, really sensitive skin, this is a big standout product. I actually love the way this works. Good job, Nutrium. My last favorite serum of 2020. I think this is like top tier, probably holy grail. As I mentioned, I love azelaic acid, one of my favorite ingredients. It just does so much for my skin, and my skin really sees a lot of benefits from it. So when I saw Nutrium came out with an azelaic acid serum, I was like, Susan Yara. Yeah. In her own video, she was like, if you were to get any of my topical acids, azelaic acid has to be the one. And she is right. As I mentioned with the Facetheory azelaic acid, it does a lot for the skin. For me specifically, I love it for my acne. I love it for my texture. I love it for the anti-inflammatory and skin balancing properties. This is a nice lightweight vehicle that the azelaic acid is in. So if I need more hydration, perfect. If I need to take care of all those other issues, perfect. Not only that, but it features niacinamide again. So you're getting all the benefits of niacinamide coupled with azelaic acid. So your skin barrier, golden. And then you also have vitamin C. So the niacinamide, azelaic acid, and vitamin C is going to be a powerhouse of antioxidants, of skin brightening, of anti-inflammatory benefits. So your skin's going to be golden. All this for less than $25. So if you were to get any of these, top recommendation right here. Hands down. So with that, those are my top favorite serums of 2020. So again, if you wanna see the most results with addressing specific skin concerns, serums are where it's at. Use these after you cleanse underneath your moisturizer. And these are where your active ingredients are really going to be at and really good concentrations to address specific concerns you got. So with that, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and notification bell so that you know when I post more skincare, sunscreen, and fenty related content on my channel. Give this video a thumbs up and down below. What were some of your favorites of the products that I mentioned, or what are some of your favorite serums of 2020? Sound off in the comments. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.